the doctor. You're unfortunately the bearer of bad news.
Oh, yeah, right at the start. Way to get to like get an audience on my side. No, yeah. So I make that call for the quarantine in the island very early on in the show.
Yeah.
And the guy does it, and it's really stressful.
Yeah.
And I'm stuck there writing like near ground zero, patient zero, and there's a lot of stress, and I'm trying to hide that stress to write this.
Because
people are looking to me for answers, and I'm freaking out inside, but I have to hide it. So.
Well, interesting you say that, because when we've been talking to the other actors, you know, they're saying for their characters, a lot of it is, you know, would they step up to the game? How would they react in that situation? But I think from a clinical standpoint, yeah, as a doctor, you'd be like, no, this is fact. This is what it is. This is how it is. With no ulterior motive, really.
It's not. It's for me, it's not about being a hero or whatever. You know, it's just doing my job as much as I can. And it's what, and I know people are looking to me for us. I'm like, what does this mean? What's going on? Why is it happening so quickly, this virus, which can actually happen? Sometimes I don't have all the answers as my character, but at the same time I can't go, oh no, because maybe halfway through the show I just do it. But you will see how the characters develop. It's not predictable. You don't know how people react in these situations. So when there's pressure cooking, that is a containment outside as well. What happens to you when this happens to you? And I love the way we ask the audience this.
Do you think that your character agrees with Dr. Lerman's decision?
The decision for you?
Well, the recording was your idea. I get the impression she's going to do a little bit above and beyond.
Yeah, I always try and disseminate the information to Cody Black's character, as you say. So it's a question of when times like this, when everything hits the fan, you know, you've got to sort of try and get some protocol and try and sort of have a structure, people to listen to, who to take orders from. Will there be a mutiny? Will there be something like that? To that effect from any of the characters, we don't know. We'll have to find out. We don't know what's going to happen, because it's so, that's why, like, the show's so honest about what you would do in this situation. It's almost controlled chaos, trying to control chaos, really.
It seems like your character very much is, you know, a scientist, and he wants to do his job and find a cure or something to help, but you kind of keep having to confront humanity and how they're reacting to this virus. Can you talk about that a little bit?
So what, humanity versus the scientific side of the brain?
Yeah.
Well, that is more like how other people are reacting to my character. Yeah, I mean, again, it's people looking for answers, really. Especially early on in the show, well, throughout, really, is like, what's going on with this planet? What's this going on? What does this mean? And I'm afraid, I'm scared. As in, they're telling me I'm afraid. I'm scared as well. But when you tell your doctor something, you don't want your doctor to go, oh, God. Seriously? Is that? Oh. And really? And look surprised? Look freaked out? You don't want that to happen. You go to another doctor if that happens. So you try and. He's had that doctor patient mentality, but he's also seen it to a degree. He's done his research, he's done his epidemic training, but he's never done it this scale. And he has to step up to the plate in a way, but not in that sort of heroic way, which you'll see other characters maybe do, or maybe cannot do, we don't know. But it's just in the way he knows, or the way he's been trained for, and you try and do it the best you can in such a crisis.